It's been 2 years since Needham spring athletes were able to put on their jerseys and play for their hometown. The wait is finally over as spring sports are set to kick off with games this week. Sports producer Kristen Connors sat down with Needham High School Athletic Director Dan Lee to give an update on what this spring season will look like.
What does it mean to know that these spring athletes are going to get a chance at a full spring season this year, especially after what happened last year?
Oh, it means everything. All along, really since August, our goal was to maximize the season for the spring athletes because they lost their entire season last year. So the rest of the sports from the fall and the winter and the fall too, they're sports that were able to run last year. And it was tough, but we were able to provide an experience for them this year. But it's really great for these spring athletes who lost their entire season last year. We haven't really played high school sports in 2 years now. When we got out there, it was really unbelievable to watch them get out there. And when we started these tryouts and practices last week, it was just a nice feeling to get out there and go around and see all the sports that were taking place and see how much that the kids and the coaches appreciated being out there.
I know you mentioned that there are a lot of sports happening. Can you tell us what sports are happening during the spring?
One of the challenges has been throughout the first three seasons with all the COVID protocols and modifications that we only had maybe four or five sports running at a time. And now we have close to 20 sports running. So our traditional spring sports like softball and baseball, lacrosse, tennis, volleyball, track, ultimate frisbee, sailing. We also have sports that weren't able to run earlier in the year that we're now, we've pushed their season to the spring. So cheer and dance are having their second season this spring. We're starting up wrestling because they weren't able to go. And we've been very happy that throughout the course of the entire year, we have successfully been able to run all of our sports with the exception of water polo, which just with the close contact of that and being in the water and not being able to wear masks was the one thing that we couldn't do safely.
So previous seasons this year, like fall and winter, were shortened. That's different though for the spring this year. Is it a normal traditional season or is it still shortened?
It's a little bit more condensed, but we're trying to, like I said, our goal has been to maximize the experience for the spring athletes. So traditionally the spring season would run from the third Monday in March, and the regular season would run through the first week in June, and then you'd have a state tournament. Whereas now we officially started the Monday after April vacation, so April 26th. And our regular season will run through roughly the middle of June. And then there'll be an opportunity for a state tournament for some of the varsity sports.
Do you know if there are going to be any restrictions as far as spectators allowed?
We've been always following the guidelines from the EEA. And then we have additional restrictions for things that take place inside school buildings. And those rules came down from the school administration. And so for outdoor sports in the fall two season, the guidelines were, it was restricted to, two parents or guardians. And that guidelines have shifted probably towards the end of the fall two season to go back to what it was in the fall, which was the percentage of capacity. So we don't have and none of our fields outside have a fence around them. We don't have like a traditional stadium where there are one or two points of entry. So all of our fields that are spread out all around town, people can walk up to it, but we just ask that they stay socially distanced and have a mask, and it will be similar to how it was in the fall.
What about like for boys volleyball inside the gym?
As of right now, we're staying with the no spectators. We were able to for basketball and girls volleyball, have parents of senior players in for a senior night. But that situation is fluid, and we'll have continuing dialogue with the school administration. And if we can allow some fans in there, we'll certainly explore it.
Is there anything that you haven't mentioned that you wanted to get out there?
I'd like to thank the players and the families all year long for following the protocols and modifications. And a similar message that's going out there, even within the state, is that to stay vigilant and stay on top of the guidelines and protocols. I think we're in a better spot, obviously, with the pandemic than we were even last fall. And so I think there's the sense of people letting their guard down, and we want to be able to complete a full season. And if guidelines, are eased up, whether it's around masks or around fans, that we'll adapt with it. But right now, just for everyone to stay the course and let's have a great spring season.